Hello and welcome to another Pop Culture Reacts and more from the spreadsheet.
We are rinsing through your spreadsheet like it's going out of fashion.
We are definitely spreadsheeting our way through the selections. And if you want to put more in the spreadsheet.
And learning a lot about you guys and the music that you like. And finding out whether we like it too.
Exactly. So this one is from Eric from Wrestling 20 Years Ago. And this is Laura Marling. And we're going with Ghost because the song that he asked for, there's not actually a proper video for that wasn't some sort of phone footage.
We did try, didn't we? Because we thought, oh, we'll go with a live version. But there was no good live versions, like camera work poor, or the very small snippets that we listened to sounded like us singing down here at you. So we thought we'll actually call an audible, go with the same artist, but get a different song. Laura Marling, mean anything to you?
Nothing.
So I actually own a couple of albums, and I've gone for one that is not from an album that I own, a British folk singer. So we kind of have hit a bit of a folk bit, and after like kind of last time out, going, I quite like folk music. It's quite nice to kind of revisit that, although, as I say, not by choice, more by someone else's pick. But solo singer. We said it on the last episode when we did the Estonian bit about how you could easily see them being the world band on Jules Holland. I think the first time I ever saw Laura Marling was on Jules Holland, and it has that kind of easily fits into the Jules Holland kind of guest. I really like her. I think she's got a really nice voice, and I've tended to find that her songs are either kind of quite poignant at the very least, but often just very nice to listen to. Now, we used the term nice in a previous episode, a different kind of nice for me, like a really compelling nice, that really interesting, yes, I could listen to more of this nice, and you watch, this one is going to be bollocks now that I've given it that hype.
Built it all up, watch it fall down.
Yeah. One of the reasons why we picked this one, as I say, is not only because it's one that I hadn't heard, but also it did look like it's got quite a cool, quirky video, hopefully. So at the very least, if you don't like the song, you might get something visually pleasing. And I'm not talking about Lacey.
So let's find some ghosts.
Let's find ghosts. Right, let's go.
He walked down a busy street, staring solely at his feet, clutching pictures of past lovers at his side. Stood at the table where she sat, and removed his hat, in respect of her presence. Presents her with the pictures and says, these are just ghosts that broke my heart before I met you. These are just ghosts that broke my heart before I met you. Opened up his little heart, unlocked the lock that kept it dark. Read a written warning, saying I'm still mourning over ghosts, over ghosts, over ghosts, over ghosts that broke my heart before I met you. Lover, please do not fall to your knees. It's not like I believe in everlasting love. He went crazy at 19, said he lost all his self-esteem and couldn't understand why he was crying. He would stare at empty chairs, think of the ghosts who once sat there. The ghosts that broke his heart, oh, the ghosts that broke my heart. The ghosts that broke his heart, oh, the ghosts that broke my heart. The ghosts, the ghosts, the ghosts, the ghosts, the ghosts, the ghosts, the ghosts that broke my heart before I met you. Lover, please do not fall to your knees. It's not like I believe in everlasting love. He says, I'm so lost, not at all well.
Before we go on to anything else, I want to get some little skeleton bodies for us. I don't think I've got the video editing skills to do it, but I want at least at some point us to have a react where we have little skeleton bodies hanging under our heads on here. But don't hold your breath on that, because as I say, the skills might not back up the desire.
May take a while. I like that. That was. It reminds me of like Frank Turner and Tom Robinson and things like that. So it's just like, you know, someone at their guitar.
Yeah.
And the truth.
And I think one of the things, and I guess problematically, you could argue that it's such a trope in folk that does it make it special anymore? But I love her voice, and I think her voice, and this is where folk music really grabs me, or when folk music grabs me, should I say, is her voice becomes almost another instrument, because it goes on so well with how that acoustic guitar is and any other instruments in it. And I just think like kind of she lilts up and down with the song,
yeah,
well, and it really captures me. And British folk especially, but I guess because we are more used to it, I like to hear their accents come through with the singing. I mean, we so often see that. I mean, it's quite a remarkable thing, isn't it? Is you can hear someone talk and they've got the broadest accent in the world, and then all of a sudden they sing and they go accentless. But yeah. That's, I quite like that in folk, is that it tends to not hide away their actual kind of natural accent.
Yeah. This very much is Glastonbury Latitude, the sort of festival soundtrack that I expect to see when I'm watching festival highlights, those sort of a festival. You know,
yeah, yeah.
Playing on a Sunday.
Yeah, probably like a smaller stage, but not like the rammed crowd, but everyone there is probably recovering from a heavy night before and really happy to be listening to what they're listening to, because it kind of pulls them along. I mean, for me, this is something that I could easily see myself on a Sunday afternoon, whacking this on in the background as I did some reading, or to be honest, where a lot of my music's done is, if it's a nice sunny day, sat out the back having a fag, listening to something that I quite like while I'm doing that. But yeah, I've listened to, as I say, other albums of hers before, and I'm a big fan. This didn't change my mind at all. In fact, if anything, I went, why have I only got a couple of her albums listening to this? Why don't I have the album this is from? I really liked it.
Yeah, it's definitely one of those of, I will probably chuck her in my rotation for Spotify and sort of like, you know, Sunday afternoons or whatever. If I just want something on in the background while I'm doing housework.
And like, I know we kind of deliberately picked out the one that looked like it had the quirkiest video. I really enjoyed that video as well. I thought it was great fun. I think I'm always kind of drawn, and I'm going to say to more simplistic things. Probably was quite difficult to put that together, but almost that simplistic kind of faux animated and faux kind of practical effects imagery. Yeah. And I just think it comes together really well and fit the song. You know, like I think it's albeit with a kind of sad message behind it, a fun rhythm to the song and a fun video, but then also that had its darker and sadder moments to it. So, yeah, big fan.
Definitely a fun video, and works really well for what it is. So yeah,
even though we've got a lot of Eric picks on the spreadsheet, feel free, Eric, to reload. You can come again, mate.
So as always, like, subscribe, ring the bell, do all of the YouTubey things, comments, so Sed can have more for his spreadsheet.
Spreadsheet.
As you all know, he needs to fill his spreadsheet. And until next time. Bye.